Greetings. Dear Muslims, I know you claim to respect Jesus as a prophet. It is a very enticing claim in your dua to trick and convert Christians. Yes, we love Jesus, peace be upon him, as a prophet, more than Christians. That would be nice, if it were true. But that is why it is such an enticing lie. It would be nice, if it were true. But over and over, Muslims, you prove you have no regard for what Jesus said. Let's take one example, one teaching by Jesus that Islam utterly rejects. The teaching of the Comforter, the promised Holy Spirit. Let's see exactly what Jesus said about the Comforter, O Muslim. John 14:15, if you love me, keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may abide with you forever. The Comforter will live with Christians forever. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But you know him, for he dwells with you, and shall be in you. The Comforter is invisible, already known, and lives with the disciples. The lie of Islam forces you to ignore these statements by Jesus about the Comforter. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things, and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. The Comforter will teach all things and remind us of what Jesus said. Can you name one teaching from the Bible that Mohammed reminds us Jesus said? How about turn the other cheek? Islam seems to have flushed that down the toilet that Allah swears by. How about love your enemies? Where in the Quran does Muhammad remind us to love our enemies? Perhaps it was on a sheet of homework paper and eaten by the pigs that he swears by. But when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth which proceeds from the Father, he shall testify of me, and you also shall bear witness, because you have been with me from the beginning. So where exactly does Mohammed testify Jesus is the Son of God? This is what Jesus claimed and said of himself. If Mohammed is the Comforter, where does Mohammed testify to Jesus as the Son of God? If Mohammed does not, he is not testifying of Jesus the Son of God. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth, it is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. Two critical points Islam is clueless about in this reference. One, Jesus said he would send the Comforter, so Jesus is Allah if Muhammad is the Comforter. Because Islam claims Muhammad was sent by Allah, and in parallel claims Muhammad was sent by Jesus. Therefore, Jesus must be the Allah that Islam thinks sent Muhammad. Point 2. Why was Jesus in such a rush to leave, a rush to send Muhammad, if Muhammad still did not come for 600 years? The lie of Islam that Mo is the Comforter just does not make any sense. And when he is come, he will reprove the world of sin, and of righteousness, and of judgment. Of sin, because they believe not on me. On righteousness, because I go to my Father, and you see me no more. Of judgment, because the prince of this world is judged. Jesus said the world must believe on him, not on the Quran, or Islam, or Muhammad, or even Allah. I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. Jesus said there were things, truths, and mysteries that their unaided human mind simply could not bear, handle, or fathom. I have never, ever heard anything out of Islam that is a revelation the simplest mind could not bear. And Islam has nothing it can ever offer, as so deep, so mysterious, or so incomprehensible? O Muslim, name one teaching Mohammed has revealed that is new. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of Truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth, for he shall not speak of himself. But whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. Jesus said the Spirit of Truth would enable and empower them to be guided into the truth. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine and shall show it unto you. All things that the Father has are mine. Therefore said I, that he shall take of mine and shall show it unto you. Jesus said the Spirit of Truth would receive of mine. And then Jesus explained what that meant. All things the Father, Almighty God, has, all that he owns, is mine. Therefore I said, that he shall take of mine and shall show it unto you. Believe Jesus and reject the lies of Islam. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. Four times Jesus expressly used you, meaning the disciples he was speaking to. Islam's lie would force you to believe Jesus lied to his disciples. Nevertheless, I tell you, the disciples, the truth. It is expedient for you, my disciples, that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you, my disciples. But if I depart, I will send him unto you, my disciples. Four times Jesus expressly used you, meaning the disciples he was speaking to. Islam's lie wants to claim you means the Arabs who will live 600 years after Jesus is gone. Four times Jesus expressly used you, meaning the disciples. This is a promise to the disciples. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. Islam's lie requires Issa to be thinking this while he lies to his Muslim followers. Oh hell, Muhammad's not coming for 600 years, not until long after you're all long dead, gone, and forgotten. But the words Jesus spoke completely damn that claim by Islam, if you respect what Jesus said. There is no rational way to ignore what Jesus said, O you who call yourself Muslim. Until the day in which he was taken up, after that he, through the Holy Ghost, had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen. This is the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, fulfilling what Jesus said. He shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I have said unto you. You see, the work of the apostles and the writing of the New Testament was empowered by the Comforter. O Muslim, you risk your eternity on the claim that an angel whispered in a man's ear, an angel no one else saw. But Christians have the confidence and assurance that God lives in us in the Holy Spirit. We may know God, while in Islam you never can. To whom also he, Jesus, showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. Jesus walked and ate and lived with them for 40 days after he rose from the dead, and he proved he was alive again. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which, saith he, you have heard of me. And here we have Jesus commanding men in 30 AD, or roughly that time, to wait for the Comforter, the Spirit of Truth promised from God. Or you can believe the lie of Islam that Jesus was telling them to wait 600 years for Mohammed. For John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. Not many days hence. Days, not years, and definitely not 600 years. So here we have Jesus commanding men in 30 AD to wait for the Comforter, the Spirit of Truth promised from God. Or you can believe the lie of Islam that Jesus was telling them to wait 600 years for Muhammad. But you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem, and in Judea, and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. The Comforter brought the power to witness, the power to turn the world upside down. With the Comforter, the Christians had the power to spread the gospel all around the known world, even to the Arabian Peninsula, enough to provoke the jealousies of pagan Arabs, where an ambitious young man would get an idea, but not an idea from God or from the Comforter or from the Christians. But that is another tale to tell in another video. The Bible records a consistent, coherent, and complete teaching of the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Truth. And these are Jesus' own words, O Muslims. Do not claim you respect Jesus with a peace be upon him tossed in, and reject his words. Then opened he their understanding, that they might understand the Scriptures, and said unto them, Thus it is written, and thus it behooved Christ to suffer, and to rise from the dead the third day. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. Again, Jesus said, Wait in Jerusalem until the promise of the Comforter comes. Wait. Days, power, the promise, the Holy Spirit, the Comforter in you, forever, empowering you. Jesus repeats that the Comforter will be bringing power, power to be witnesses and more. The lie of Islam would have you believe Jesus commanded men to wait 600 years for Muhammad to come to strangers in a strange land. And why do people in Islam reject what Jesus said? What could possibly be the reason to ignore what Jesus said? Islam tells a second lie, that the Bible has been corrupted, and these are not the words Jesus spoke. And let's take a look at Islam's lie for a moment. You are free to think men who saw miracles and knew the Son of God, men who were promised eternal life by the Son of God, whom they saw raised from the dead, men who knew and experienced the Holy Spirit leading them and teaching them. You are free to believe these men, who all went to their deaths holding constant their faith and their pious beliefs. You are free to believe these men lied and schemed and changed the message of Jesus, even though the recorded history of these events are in complete agreement and make perfect sense. You are free to believe someone somewhere somehow changed the Word of God regarding the central event in human history. You are free to believe Jesus lied to his Muslim followers and promised them help and a comforter Jesus knew would never come to them. And you are free to believe Islam's confused and conflicted story. You can believe Muhammad is the invisible man Jesus spoke about. You can believe Muhammad is the eternal man Jesus said would live with Christians forever. But sadly, you are damning yourself with your willingness to accept such stupidity. Christians, I beg you to hold fast to the truth of the gospel and do not fall for the lies of Islam. As Paul the Apostle wrote, O foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you, that you should not obey the truth, before whose eyes Jesus Christ has been evidently set forth crucified among you? Do not let Satan bewitch you, brother, that you should believe the lies of Islam. Islam will spread. Do not let that ever be an argument to convince you it is good. There will be a great falling away. 2 Thessalonians 2:3. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there first come a falling away, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. Do not let the falling away convince you the gospel is weak or false. Remember instead, God has foretold these things that you might be warned and prepared. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.